Argireline is by far the closest ingredient that we have to Botox in a cream form. Otherwise known as acetyl hexapeptide 8, Argireline is a peptide that has received a lot of attention all over the internet, primarily due to TikTok, thanks to its skin tightening effects and potential anti-aging properties that a lot of you are after, especially when you're trying to get rid of those crow's feet and the infamous 11s or glabellar lines. In this video, you'll want to stay tuned because we'll be going over what is Argireline, what its benefits are, how to use it to get the results you want, and most importantly, the biggest issue with Argireline that a lot of influencers don't mention, which you'll want to stay tuned to not miss. If you guys are new here, this channel is all about helping you make informed decisions as well as be in the know when it comes to your health and wellness. And I would love for you all to gently tap on that like button down below. And if you really like the content, then I'd love for you all to subscribe as well. Now, without further ado, let's dive into what is Argireline. Argireline is a peptide, and it's not just any peptide. It's one of those most trusted anti-aging peptides out there. But what are peptides? Peptides are short chains of amino acids shaping the foundation for proteins, which include your collagens and your elastins, which are vital to looking young. What makes it even more interesting is the fact that it is patterned from the N-terminal end of the protein SNAP25, which can both reduce facial wrinkles that are already present on the skin, as well as work against the wrinkles that may be already developing, so you can catch them early and prevent them. This is because Argireline affects nerve to muscle communication so that the muscles can't adequately contract, causing them to become relaxed, which is similar to the effects of Botox minus the needles, of course. And when our facial muscles are relaxed, they promote a visible reduction in the appearance of wrinkles. One thing that is important to mention is that unlike Botox, Argireline is not a toxin. It's a peptide, and it should not damage the skin or cause any adverse reactions to it. The supposed benefits of Argireline are basically three primary benefits that you should achieve after using it twice a day for 4 weeks. And yes, that's the protocol. Two times a day for about a month. You should see some type of result by then. And what those three benefits are, you might ask. The first is that it prevents the formation of dynamic wrinkles. And specific examples include your crow's feet, which you find in athletes caused by years of squinting at the sun, or the lines that form around the mouth from smoking cigarettes, as well as those smile lines, which are those telling signs of aging skin. The second benefit is that it can stimulate collagen production. And this is important because with more collagen, collagen being the protein responsible for firm, healthy skin, it will help keep fine lines and wrinkles from forming down the line, especially since collagen declines in your early 30s. And the last benefit is it can help your skin retain more moisture, since it can help improve the function of collagen itself. So there you go. If you're trying to treat wrinkles and prevent them from getting worse, you want to stimulate collagen and help your skin retain more moisture by improving the function of collagen, then Argireline is a product to consider. But how do you use it? When it comes to using Argireline, there are so many products to choose from, so the instructions will differ and you should follow the instructions on the packaging. But for example, probably the most popular product and the least expensive one is the 10% Argireline by The Ordinary. You'd want to use it morning and night around your eyes and on your forehead before applying any other products. And you might ask, what would be the drawbacks of using it though? While not everyone has side effects with Argireline, if you have sensitive skin, you may experience stinging at first, as well as redness and dry, flaky skin at some of those contact points, which is why I recommend patch testing first. The manufacturers also advise applying products that contain a peptide to sunburned or irritated skin, so avoid it around areas if you're going through a sunburn or irritation. The issue is that there is a lack of clinical research conducted with argireline, and the studies on human subjects are very limited. And without conclusive double-blind clinical studies, argireline's efficacy remains somewhat murky, and I'm not totally convinced. Although it appears to be a successful wrinkle fighter when applied to aging and thinner skin, and a lot of the times people have found success with wrinkle reduction with it as well, something you should keep in mind in the back of your head is that it may not function as well when used on a thicker epidermis. And what do I mean by that? When looking at this article about anti-wrinkle peptides and skin permeation, they found that argireline has a high molecular weight of 889 Dalton, above the 500 Dalton rule we talk about on this channel. This means that argireline remains mainly on the surface of the skin upon topical application and not deeper in it. And the way to fix that is several research groups have attempted to enhance the transdermal delivery by structurally modifying the amino acid side chains to increase the lipophilicity to get the active in deeper. And what they found is that the Arch2 and Arch3 analogs of argireline had consistently greater entry through the skin after 24 hours, while Arch1 had consistently less cumulative amount of peptide permeated through the skin after 24 hours as compared to regular argireline, which struggled. So bottom line, we don't know how exactly if the argireline we have in our products are structurally enhanced enough to get deeper into the skin to solve the big issue at hand, aging. And to summarize everything I just said, you can pretty much say that results may vary. And if you're in the market for an alternative to argireline that is anti-aging and wrinkle fighting, I prefer products like retinoids, growth factor, and peptide-based creams. And one of my favorites right now is the First Aid Beauty Skin Lab Resurfacing 10% AHA, which brightens, tightens, and reduces fine lines that you can pick up down below in the description box of this video. Click the red subscribe button down below, and I'll see you on the next one.